iOS 17 introduced a great way to guide new users through your app with TipKit. TipKit is a framework that allows you to easily show these tooltips and set up rules to make sure you're showing them at the appropriate times. Now, with great power comes great responsibility, because what you're seeing on the screen right now might not be the best way to use them, right? You don't want to plaster every button, every view in your app with tooltips, right? That's a horrible user experience. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to implement these tips, set up rules to show them at the appropriate times, and talk about when and when you should not use them. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. Here I am in Xcode, and because I want to focus on tips, I have a basic starter project. Let me run through that real quick. It is a scroll view that has a for each that shows random colors in a rounded rectangle, as you see on the right. I have mock data down here, which is just for color.randoms, and this extension on color is what gives me the random color, and that is what I'm using in my for each to populate those four colors you see on the right. There is a context menu. If you hold down on a color, you can see you can set it as favorite, but you notice that's kind of hidden. So that's a good example of when to use a tip, which we'll touch on later. But the premise of the app, right, you can add random colors by hitting the plus button in the upper right, and you can see us adding it there. And if you want access to the completed source code, check out the link in the description. Before we write the code for our first tip, let's talk about some big picture best practices on when you should and shouldn't use them. Common examples from Apple's WWDC presentation on this, which I highly recommend you check out, is to teach someone about a new feature, help them discover a hidden feature, and show someone a faster way to accomplish something. And tips should be quick, instructional, and easy to remember. Don't use them for promotional stuff or error messages or super long instructions. And if you want to dive deeper on best practices for these tips, check out the tip section in Apple's Human Interface Guidelines. The link will be in the description. Okay, so that's the big picture on when you should and shouldn't use a tip. Later in this video, we'll get into the details of setting up rules so you can only show your tip in certain situations. For example, we only want to show this set favorites tip if they haven't set a favorite before and if they visited the screen a certain number of times. But first, let's start with the basics and work our way up, and we're going to create this popover tip. So the first thing we need to do is create a tip, and I'm going to put these in a separate file. So in TipKit example, right click, new file, Swift file. I'm going to call this tip, hit create, import TipKit. And then now we want a struct, and we'll call this add color tip, and we'll conform to the tip protocol. Now it's going to give us an error saying, hey, you don't conform to the protocol. There you go. Let's add the stubs. So the basic thing you need, like the absolute minimum, is a title, and you can see it is a text. So we'll return text. It says add new color. Now we want more than a title, so I'm going to add message. You can see I get the autocomplete here. So this is not me making up this name. This is a property on here. And you see it's optional. So make sure you don't delete that optional. You're gonna need that. And this is also a text. So we'll have our message say, tap here to add a new color to the list. And we're gonna add an image for this one. You don't have to have an image, but again, I'm just demonstrating. So again, image, this one is optional as well. And we'll do image of system name paint palette. This is an SF symbol that I have memorized apparently. Okay, this is a basic tip. We have our struct of tip, we have a title, message, and an image. We'll create a little more complex one in the second example, but we're starting with the basics. So back to the content view, now I need to show the tip. So here on our toolbar button, we're gonna add a popover, that popover tip, and you can see it takes in a tip, arrow edge, and an action. We don't have any actions. This might be something like a learn more button that you see in this image here. The arrow edge, you can specify where the arrow edge is coming from. Now, if you're dealing with a toolbar button like we are, this can be finicky, and if you use one that doesn't work, it just won't show up. So I try to let the system choose it whenever it can, but just to let you know, you can specify the arrow edge. Now, popover tip, we don't have a tip yet. So up here in our view, let's say, let add color tip equal add color tip, initialize a new one. So now we will pass that in here on line 37, add color tip. All right, so we've done step one and two. Step one was to create our tip, which we did here. Step two was to actually call it somewhere with a popover tip or a tip view, which you'll see in the next example. And then the third step, well, actually, you could argue this is the first step. If we go to our app, we have to configure our app to use tips. So here in our app on the content view, do dot task, and the code will say try tips dot configure. And I cheated. I already have TipKit imported. You probably have to import that. That was me practicing for this. So anyway, make sure you have TipKit imported. So tips dot configure. And we want configuration options here. So if I return, see this is an array of tips.configuration options. Now, the one you're certainly gonna want is to determine where your data store is. So .data store location, you can see the locations, got application default, group container. This is where you'll see later in the tutorial, we're going to like donate our events, and this is where it keeps track of all that stuff. That'll make sense later in the video. We'll come back to that. Another option you might want is to have the display frequency. Now what this is, as you can see, we see daily, hour, immediate, monthly, we'll put immediate for now, but what this is here for is, let's say you had 5 tips on your home screen for some reason. They're all valid reasons to have 5 tips. Well, when your user opens your app, you don't want to just boom, throw 5 tips at them all at once and just shove it in their face. So what this will do is this will make sure only 1 tip per day shows, or 1 tip per hour, 1 tip per month. If you do immediate, that is when you're going to spam your user with all the tips. So use whatever frequency makes sense for you. I'm gonna put immediate here now for like testing purposes, but actually we're gonna comment that out. But I wanted to point out the purpose of that. So now that our content view is configured with tips, we should be good to go. But real quick, I'm gonna bring this over to our preview so we can see the tips here in our preview. And let's run it to test it out, see if we see our tip. Our preview should be showing it. I'm not sure what I did wrong there. But there's our tip. Okay, looks like paint palette isn't showing. Let's go to SF symbols. Maybe I typed that wrong. Paint. Palette, oh, I probably misspelled it knowing me. So back to our tip, the image of the system name is paint palette, run it again. There it is, okay, I guess I did spell it wrong, or I did something wrong. But there is our tip with the image. Now let me stop this and go back to our preview because that's confusing me. It should be showing up on our preview. Hit refresh, it is not showing up. Let's try resetting the data store. Try tips.reset data store on our preview every time. There we go. So how tips work, once your tip gets invalidated, it won't show up again. So especially for debugging or your preview, you want to reset the data store all the time. So you reset any of the conditions that invalidate and don't show your tip. But if you want to test your invalidation and your rules, which we'll do in a little bit, it's best to run it on the simulator. So I got distracted there because my preview wasn't working. Let's rerun this on the simulator. There's our tip. I want to talk about this invalidation because when the user hits the X, you don't have to do anything. It automatically invalidates. They won't see the tip again. But if I just hit the plus for the add new color, I added a color, and then if I stop it, rerun it, I should see the tip again. Yep, there's the tip, but I already added a color. So we want to invalidate the tip when the user does the action that we want. So again, you can invalidate it either by hitting the X, but you also want to make sure that when they add something, you invalidate it as well. So up here in the button, right when we tap it and we insert the random color at 0, we will do add color tip dot invalidate. And the reason is action performed, right? They've added a color, they no longer need to see the tip. So now when we run it, there it is. I'm gonna hit the plus button to add a color, cool. Stop it, rerun it, and then I shouldn't see the tip because it has been invalidated because we performed the action. And if you want to reset your simulator just for like testing notes here, go back to your app, add that, try tips.resetDataStore. You can also do tips.showAllTips for testing, which will show all your tips no matter what, or you can pass in an array of certain tips you want to show. This is all for like testing purposes. I'm just gonna reset the data store because we're gonna start working on our rules here in a second. So when I run this, the data store will be reset. I see the tip. Now, like I just mentioned, we can set up rules to only show this at certain times. So I also said that this is probably bad to spam your user right away with the plus button because that's kind of the obvious action. But let's say your user launched the app 10 times and they still haven't added a color. Well, then now maybe that's a reasonable place to be like, hey, you can add a color by hitting this plus button. And that is done by setting up rules. So to show you that, we're gonna implement this tip you see here about letting them know they can favorite a color, but we're only gonna show this tip if they've never set a favorite before and they visited the screen a certain number of times. Okay, so we'll stop running this and start setting up our next tip. So we'll go to our tips file and we'll create another tip very similar. So I'm gonna actually copy and paste, save a little time here. And we're gonna call this the set favorite tip, set favorite tip. The title is going to be set favorites and the message will be tap and hold a color to add it to your favorites. And for this one, we're not gonna have an image, just to show you the image is optional. And a quick note, you can style this text. So on our add color tip, I'll say foreground style dot teal. I didn't style our set favorite tip title because I'm gonna change the background of the tip to teal and that would have clashed, but I'll show you the add color tip. You'll see the title will now be teal. So that's the basis of my tip, just a title and a message. Let's get this showing up in the UI and then we'll come back and implement our rules. So into the content view. Now, before we did the popover tip, if I refresh my preview, you should see our title now, the different color. There it is, see add new color. That's the popover tip. The other option you have is what's called a tip view, which will put a view inline. So here in our scroll view, I have 4 each with rounded rectangles. That's all the colors you see. So above that list of colors, I'm gonna do tip view. And the tip I'm gonna pass in is going to be, oh, I gotta create it. Let set favorite tip equal set favorite tip. And in the tip view, I'm going to now show that set favorite tip. And you should see it in our UI, spamming all the tips. So I'm gonna close out the add new color. Now, there is our set favorites. As you can see, that is just the title and the message, but you can style this a little bit. So on our tip view, there's something called tip background. And with the other stuff, you can see you have tip corner radius, tip view style, tip image size. You can really customize these. Again, that gets deeper, but you can create your own custom tip view style that you see here to completely make it your own. For us, I'm just gonna do some basic stuff here. Tip background, I'm gonna say .teal, except I'm going to do opacity of 0.2, just to give it a little tint, if you will. Let's get rid of our add new color. But you can see why you don't wanna show all your tips at once, because it's just, it's a mess. But there's our set favorites tips UI. Now let's set up our rules. And again, the rule is they've never set a favorite before, and they visited this screen, we'll say at least 3 times. 3 is a completely arbitrary number that you would pick for your app. And that's a good time to pause and have a quick note on these tips. These tips can get very, very complex, and they're super unique to your app and your product. You know, what features are your users not discovering? You can either figure that out intuitively or let your analytics tell you. And then what is the best way to show this tip to nudge your user into using that feature? Again, these are all super unique to your product, and these tips can get very, very complex. So if you want to do a deeper dive, I recommend checking out the WWDC session. Again, link will be in the description. Okay, let's set up some rules. So over in our tip, this is where we set up rules. Just like title and message and image, you type rule, there is a rule property, and that takes an array of rules, which you don't actually have to use the brackets because we use the rule macro. But let me back up and give you the big picture of how these rules work. So we'll create this rule that you'll see here, and then all throughout our app, we need to donate events. An example of an event would be, you know, setting a color as favorite or visiting the colors list screen. So we keep track of all these events, and then when we're checking our rules, we use all those events that have been donated to determine should we show the tip or not. Okay, that was big picture. It'll make more sense once we code it up. Okay, so the first rule we want, to do this based on events. So now we need an event. That's simple enough. So we'll say static let set favorite event equal an event with the ID of set favorite. And then we'll need another one of these, static let colors view visited event, and that equals event with the ID colors view visited. So this was just us creating the events, and then now we're going to let these rules know, hey, this is the event I want to pay attention to. So that would be self.set favorite event and event in. So now we're going to count how many times this event was donated. So the rule I want to have before I show the tip is event.donations.count equals equals 0, because I only want to show this rule when I've never set a favorite before. So now that I've created this event, and I'm going to do the trailing closure syntax here, let me go back up to the UI. When do I want to donate setting a favorite? Well, that's here in the context menu, right? When I hold a color and I get this context menu, that is when they set a favorite. So on this button tap, obviously there's actual code to set the favorite that we're not doing, just to be clear. I don't want to distract too much from the tips. And of course I misspelled favorite there, but this needs to be done in a task because it is asynchronous. We'll say await set favorite tip dot set favorite event dot donate. So this is us donating the event every time they favorite a color. And again, back to our tip, we're gonna check the count of those donations. So if they favorited 5 colors, well, the donations.count will be 5, and then we won't show our tip because it doesn't equal 0, because we only wanna show it when they've never set a favorite. So the second half of this rule is based on self.colorsViewVisited event, and then event is similar, event.donations.count greater than 2, because we'll do this on the third visit. And I'm picking a small number so I don't have to relaunch the app so many times. In reality, maybe you wanna do it after 10 visits or whatever. So now that we've set the second rule, let's make sure we're donating it at the appropriate time. So again, back to our content view, anytime they visit this view, right now it's the only view in our app, so this can be a proxy for launches, but you know, you can imagine an app that has 20 views in it. Anytime they visit a view, on appear comes up, right? On appear, and we will say basically the same thing we did up here when we donated our event. So I'll copy and paste that into on appear, except it's not set favorite events, it's colors view visited dot donate. So every time on appear fires off, we donate an event. And again, back in our tip, we're gonna check how many times we've donated that. And if it's greater than 2 and we've never set a favorite, now we're showing our tip. So let's run this. And on first launch, I should see, yep, our add new color. I will go ahead and get rid of this, invalidate it. When you hit the X, you'll never see it again. So that was launch number 1. Stop it, run it. Launch number 2, I shouldn't see the set favorites tip. Why are you invalidating this? Did I? Yep, I know why. Just reinforces the lesson here. On my app, I am resetting the data store on every launch. I don't want to do that. Okay, so now when I launch it again, data store won't restart. So I should be technically on launch number 2 for our rule count. Okay, didn't see the tip. This should be launch number 3. So now when I launch it, I should see the tip. There it is, set favorites tip. There's our styling. Again, if the user hits X, it dismisses it. But let's say they don't interact with it. Stop it, run it, launch number 4. it still shows up. We still see it. Now, if I hold down the color, set as favorite, it invalidates the tip. Little herky jerky animation there. You could probably work on that. But now I've set a favorite, so I won't see that tip. Run it again. I don't see the set favorites tip. So using these rules, you can really pinpoint the best time to give your user that little nudge to discover that new feature or find some way to do something quicker, which overall makes it better and easier to use. And if you're here learning how to make great apps, you're gonna want a place to showcase your work like an online portfolio website. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves, but I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.